body, you should hear Lady Q's in the building. Make the noise if you hear. Lift your hands right now.
Right now, right now.
Go ahead and scream out loud.
Network worldwide. LoveRadioNetwork.com. Educational, inspirational, trending topics, and the hottest hits. With award-winning talk show hosts and personalities. And you made us number one. Thank you. Luv Radio Network, building a network of love.
Ambassador Everett Robinson presents Final Authority, Mondays at 9 o'clock p.m. Eastern, teaching a sound biblical perspective that is solely based upon the authority scripture alone. Final Authority with Ambassador Everett Robinson, Mondays at 9 o'clock p.m. on LoveRadioNetwork.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is not a drill. It's the B.O.B. bout. And it's about to get real. Let's go. It's about to get real.
Watch God. Yeah. Good. Woo! Yeah. Hey, look up, okay? Woo! All right. Good morning. Guys, people, thank you so much for tuning in to the Luv Radio Network Sunday Fire. Yes. And we got some stuff going on this morning. I'm telling y'all, it's about to be on and popping. I thank y'all so much. Today we are celebrating the holiday season. As I mentioned to y'all, I posted on Facebook, made an event for it. We are doing what God has provided for us to do, and that is to come to you and to bring you music. We got some awesome music lineup today. We have some new artists. Let me tell y'all something. We are going to be featuring a lot of new artists, introducing new artists to some of you that may not be familiar with who they are. We're going to present some artists you may be familiar. Be right back.
Comfort and joy, comfort and joy, for all time. had a dream that she could do it. And how she lost her way and didn't stick to it. She wanted the house, the cars, the money. She did all that she could. In her mind, she was so focused, doing overtime in the diner. Just wanted someone to wine and dine her. She didn't believe in herself.
Believe in yourself,
you can do it.
Believe in yourself,
ain't nothing to it. Believe in yourself, even if nobody does.
Believe in yourself,
believe in yourself,
believe in yourself,
even if nobody does. Don't let nobody tell you that you can't when you can. Don't let nobody tell you that you can when you can. Tell you that you can't when you can. Oh, let nobody tell you that you can when you can. She was diagnosed with cancer. Going to the doctor for some answers. They said she wouldn't make it, she couldn't take it. She did all that she could. Getting sick from the chemo. Bank account started looking real low. She knew she could make it, she wouldn't take it. She believed in herself.
Believe in yourself, you can do it.
Self.
Believe in yourself,
ain't nothing to it. Believe in yourself, even if nobody does.
Believe in yourself, believe in yourself,
believe in yourself, even if nobody does. Don't let nobody tell you that you can't when you can. Let nobody tell you that you can when you can. Oh, let nobody tell you that you can when you can. Let nobody tell you that you can when you can.
Stars and the moon. You ought to be my light when it's dark in the room. When I depart from the room, you're the air that I breathe. I wave there when I need you. Prepare for peace. You're so good.
I got a good job. I'm good. And my bills are paid out.
Good.
And my family's good. My health is good. I thank God that I'm
good.
I got a good job. I'm
good.
And my bills are paid out. I got food on the table. I know that he's able. Thank God I'm
good.
I got a good job. I'm
good.
And my bills are paid out. And my family's good. My health is good. I thank God that I'm
to the Luv Radio Network worldwide. LuvRadioNetwork.com. Educational, inspirational, trending topics, and the hottest hits. With award-winning talk show host and personality. And you made us number one. Thank you. Luv Radio Network, building a network of love.
Good morning. Thank you all so much for staying tuned. For those of you that are just tuning in, I am your girl, Lady Q, and you are listening to Sunday Fire. All right, y'all hear how I said that? Just because the guest that I'm getting ready to introduce, let me just slow down because I'm excited, y'all. Y'all know how I do. We have an awesome, phenomenal guest. I'm going to tell you a little bit about her, just a little teeny bit, and then she's going to come and tell y'all the rest. Okay, that's all right. That's all right. I know that's right. Okay, here we go. We have in the studios, national, okay, put that respect on that, national gospel artist, Miss Shay Samuels, Miss Shay Sam, okay, national recording artist, whose singles have been charting, okay, they have been charting. One of the songs is my favorite. She's got a new song out that we're going to talk about that too. Believe in Yourself, okay, y'all, believe in yourself, you believe in yourself, because I'm good, okay, so y'all just sit right there, and we're gonna let her come on in and talk about what she's doing. Yes, give her some love. Give her some love.
Hello.
Yes, you know that's how the young folk do it.
I love it.
Yes. It is an honor and a privilege to have you in the studios with us today. Okay? Because you know it will be all right.
Yes, you know, that's you. You're doing exactly what the songs are meant to do. It's everyday talk. It's what we talk about every day. It's how we talk every day and how we need to remind ourselves every day. It will be all right.
It will. Yes, it will. So we're going to start off with your with talking about the believe in yourself. And then you'll talk about I'm good, because those songs alone, those two right there, we're going to just start with that. Tell us where you were in your thought process to even come up with that. Like, what was going on when you came up with that?
So with believing yourself, it's just who I am every day. You know, I'm a firm believer that if you live what you speak, then you don't have to think about it. So you'll never find me writing anything on paper. So it's just who I am every day. It's what my ministry has been about, getting people to walk out their purpose every day, and people identifying with their purpose and truly believing in themselves. Believe in yourself really kind of derived out of my youth. You always get told what you can't do. You know, you're always told that things are impossible. And being a young mother at the age of 16 and 17 years old, I was told I wasn't going to be able to graduate high school. I was told I was never going to be able to go to college, let alone graduate high school. My career, if I did want to have one, was gone because I had children. And so if I went with society, the tag that society put on me, I wouldn't be where I am today. But it took me to believe in myself to know that there was more out there. And I wanted other people, men, women, children, to know that if you have a vision, if you know that you have a call on your life, and even if it looks like you can't do it because of your circumstances, if you believe in yourself, that you really can accomplish all of your goals, you know. And I talk about how to set those goals. I talk about how to achieve those goals one day at a time, but you have to believe in yourself. And so that's where the song came from.
Oh, wow. See, already, I thought she was ready to start preaching. I had my hand ready to go up. Y'all should save me.
I'm good actually came out of, you know, I'm from up north, you know, shout out to my up north folks. David kind of gets upset because he's from the south, and he goes, well, south people say it too. But here's the thing, I'm from up north, so I can only speak where I came from.
Well,
and you know, Lady Q, you know, my grandmother, they used to say, like, you need anything to eat? And I would hear my mom say, no, I'm good. You know, she might say, you need some money. My aunts would say, no, I'm good. You know, and if you say hi to somebody, how you doing? Everybody say, I'm good. So I wanted to take some of my up north roots and turn it into something that we do and say every day. But the song in its entirety, it really came from my cousin who was an addict. And, you know, shout out to her because she didn't know that the song came from her. But I was watching her after she came out of recovery for years. I mean, this was a battle for years. It didn't just happen overnight. But I was watching her and kind of reintroduced. It's like a second cousin removed, but grew up with her. And her kids, unfortunately, became addicts. They became some of them became addicted to drugs. And I watched after she came home from recovery how she started spending time with her grandkids. Her life changed. She started spending time with her grandkids. She was taking vacations with all the kids. I was watching how the relationships were being reconciled. And they were putting this on Facebook. And I just started thinking about her life beforehand. And the person who maybe, you know, you rejected in society, or maybe you didn't feel like you were part of society because of things that you had done in the past. But where you are now, you can thank God for that. And so instead of reminding people of their trials and what they were going through and creating a song that would be sorrowful to remind them of their pain and their agony, I thought maybe do a song that speaks to the person who had gone through that, but that they have overcome it and they're living in that, and they have to be reminded every day to thank God because they're good.
Well. That's from my roots in the church. All right. So I like what you said, and shout out to your cousin. We celebrate her on today.
Yes.
In her recovery and her journey and process of living her best life. You know, and I, you know, I have family members that have gone through or gotten through that same process, a similar process. And it's definitely it's good to celebrate somebody instead of promoting their downfall.
Yeah.
And that's where if we can get to that point in life where we celebrate people when they overcome or come through. Now, they had to do the work.
Yes.
They had to do the work. And we are not exempt. We might have a different type of work that we have to do, but we still have to put in the work for things that we have to overcome. So we celebrate her and all those that are in recovery, that are in lifestyle transitions and all those things. We celebrate you. We love you. And we thank you. So listen to the song. I'm telling y'all, listen to that song and stay encouraged. I'm telling you, believe in yourself, number one.
Mm-hmm.
And be good.
Mm-hmm.
Just know that you're good. Those two things right there, because God got you. God got you. I'm just saying. So you mentioned that you were a single mom, teenage mom, and through, because you were like, what, high school, like 10, 11th grade?
Yes, 10th grade. I was in 10th grade. Yeah.
Right. But that's okay. That's okay. I'm going somewhere with the point. Because a lot of times people, you know, they feel like they don't have anybody. They feel like they can't get through because their environment is not, like, conducive for them to get through it. You know, some people don't have the right environment to be able to get through it, or even believe in themselves because everybody around them is telling them different. Like you said, you know, people that were close to you telling you, you know, that they were condemning you, basically. Mm-hmm. You know, well, some of how they think we got here. Everybody wasn't married. No, I'm not going to preach. See, my voice escalated right there.
Come back to the light, lady.
Okay. So people need to remember they, too, were once in. They were a child. They were teenage. They did teenage stuff, you know. So it's not the baby's fault, you know. It's however society provided whatever or didn't provide whatever, you know. I too am a product of a teenage mom.
Mm-hmm.
So my sister, you know, we came from a teenage mom, you know, and thank God that she kept us and we are here and, you know, God rest her soul. She's not here with us anymore. But, you know, a lot of times we come through in ways that doesn't seem tasteful to some.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You know what society calls.
Ooh. You better speak.
You know,
oh,
I'm yes. If I do that, if I speak, then we're gonna have to take up offering.
Ooh,
but anyway,
ooh.
Yeah, because we have to remember that, you know, we have a story too. We have skeletons. We have things that, you know. And your song, somebody needed to hear that. Somebody needs to know that. Hey, believe in yourself. You know, you gotta believe in yourself because God made you the way that he made you. You know, everything that God created was good.
Yes. And you're the one with the call. You're the one with the call. So at the end of the day, you know what you have in you. And it is a society driven world that we live in. And we're always looking either to compare ourselves or our gift to others, or we're looking at someone else and seeing how successful they've been over time. Or maybe you look at your circumstance. I don't have enough money. I don't have a car. I don't have a home. I don't have this. But what I want to encourage everyone in is knowing that you have a seed on the inside of you that's destined to grow. And that's what these songs do. These songs water the seed. Come on.
And God gives the increase.
And God gives the increase. So the Bible reminds us that one man plants, another man waters. And so that's basically what my ministry is all about. It's watering the seed, planting and watering the seed. So the songs are to encourage, but you have a call on your life, regardless of if someone told you you didn't, if you weren't appointed at church, regardless of who told you you weren't qualified, regardless if that teacher told you you would never amount to anything in this world. Mm. You know that you're here for a purpose because you were born. You were born, and everything that is born, delivered, everything that is supposed or intended to grow has a purpose. Even a rose has a purpose, Lady Q.
Yes, it does.
It's a rose, and guess what? It's born to die. People don't know that. That's a whole nother message. But while it's here, it's palliating the world, and that's what these songs encourage people to do. So I just wanted to encourage someone in that today as well.
And we're going to move on before we get slayed out here in this carpet.
Uh-oh.
We're going to move on because she said about the increase. And the increase takes you beyond the fence.
Ooh-hoo.
Well, okay. Yeah. So that's where we at. We're going beyond the fence. Tell us about that. Tell us about beyond the fence.
Yes, ma'am. So Beyond the Fence, shout out to David Benton, who is a visionary for Beyond the Fence. You guys will get a chance to meet him eventually, but he served 13 years in federal penitentiary.
Come on.
And when he came home while he was being, and I told you about that seed, he knew he had a vision while he was behind the fence. He had a
glory.
Starting a label, and he actually decided the label would be entitled Beyond the Fence, because now he's beyond the fence. And so in 2017, we began to lock arms. We bought both of our ministries together, and we decided that we were going to just keep on moving in the direction that we both knew that we could, and we're here today because of it. So Beyond the Fence is a group of individuals who each have a story of going beyond our fence.
And those, the two songs that we're going to play from the label, which is your label, correct?
Yes. Well, it's David's, it's both David. Of our labels. David
okay.
was the visionary behind it. He's the founder.
Okay.
And so it's, you know, if I say it and he hears it, he's going to be like, it's both of ours. So David was the visionary, but it's both of our labels. Yes.
Yes. Both of your labels. Thank you to the visionary. Amen. Because you need the visionary. Write the vision. Make it plain, David.
Amen.
That's all I'm saying. Okay.
Amen.
So two of the songs from that we're going to play today is Lord I.
Yes.
And also the Brand New.
Yes.
Yes, Brand New. And with those two songs, that has to do with his journey. The journey.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The good thing about having the label is I have to be a part of listening to all the music, all of the graphics we do, everything, movies, the video. If you've seen the video, I shot the video and edited the video, and David produced the video. So I have to learn everyone's song. So if you ask me any history on a song, I'm going to have it. So G Will came with us probably about 2018, and he used to be an R&B artist. Traveling with another group of people, and they were definitely a great group. And he decided again to lock arms with Beyond the Fence, going beyond his own fence. And his first single entitled Brand New came from that. And that song really was just from him knowing that he used to be, and again, you'll hear his message. I don't want to spill the beans, but he wasn't always G Will. You know, I call him G Weezy, so shout out to G Weezy. But he wasn't always G Will. And so in this song, he's really just thanking God for changing him and making him brand new. And the feature on that song, shout out to Lisi, that's his daughter. And so at the end, you know, that song made a lot of radio personalities cry because they had daughters of their own. Mm-hmm. And the song was so intimate. And the pun in that is it's like a father to a daughter. And so the reference is him naturally with his daughter, but also spiritually our father to us, the heavenly father to us.
Whoa. Well, there you have it. Well, while we rolling with it, because if I get in the spirit, then time gonna go on, and you know I don't have no ushers here with the little cloth to cover my, you know, so I'm just gonna contain myself. Okay. So, can you let the people know what platforms you're on, how they can get a hold of your music, and things of that nature, just in case they need to, you know, hit you up for an engagement or two.
Sure. Yes, ma'am. You can find us on all social media platforms and outlets by going to Beyond the Fence. That's BeyondTheFence. BeyondTheFence.org is the website. Keep in mind that we are scheduled to do a state-to-state tour in 2022. Already here, 2022. We start taking the road from Indiana to San Antonio, North Carolina, Virginia, Florida, Delaware, Philadelphia. So you can get the dates on all of that on the website. But you can get our music on all digital outlets. You know, we say that and people think because we're independent artists that just means YouTube. I'm telling you, if you hear the song and you've overcome some things, put it on your stories, put it on your reel, put it on your Twitter, put it on something that's your morning affirmation. You can get the music everywhere you will get your mainstream music. Pandora, Spotify, iHeart,
Luv Radio.
Yes, Luv Radio for sure, because they are playing it and I love it. But you can get the music everywhere. If you want to book us, make sure you schedule a time with us at www.beyondoffense.org. If you want to book the tour for your church or for a venue, definitely let us know, and we're looking forward to adding you to one of the states.
All right, there you have it, what she said. That's the part of the service where they say, well, all hearts and minds are clear. Ain't nothing else need to be said.
All hearts and minds are clear.
Yes, we thank you so much, Ms. Shay Sams, for spending time in the studio with us today. Let the people know, before you go, let the people know what show they listening to and who you rocking with.
Listen, you are listening to Sunday Fire with my sister, Lady Q, on the LuvRadioNetwork.com.
Give us some love, people. Give us some love. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Gotta say a prayer for my friend. Call me up the other morning, 4 a.m. Said he's going through some things in his life, having it hard and hadn't slept in several nights. And he's calling me to help him on his way. If I didn't mind, could I stay on the phone and pray? So I walk into the living room, and Lord, this is what I said to you. Could barely hold my eyes. Then my boss, he called me in the office by surprise. To myself, oh Lord, I put this in your hand. And with fear, I went to him, said, here I am. Close the door, I know that you're a praying man. My heart is heavy and I'm in need of counseling. I think I'm about to lose the love of my life. The doctor says she's ill, but I can't lose my wife.
But now,
and so I'm so
much for you.
will serve you, cause only you pay the price for me. Cleaned up this dirt suit, now I don't look the same. Yeah, and even though my suit's still dirt, you took my shame. Oh, I am on my way, gotta stay prayed up, can't do this on my own. And every breath I take in is a brand new stone. Giving me strength to make it through the night, yeah. Now all I can say is thank you for my life.
You are
the reason I feel brand new.
You are
because of your love, it's true.
You are
I never will be the same. Been without blame, cause I remember my back wins, and yeah, I caused some pain. See, I left a few scars on some broken hearts, and I'm not proud of those days. And if I could say sorry, I would say sorry, I'm not the same old me. See, I love you, Lord, with all my heart, and you took away my past. And if I tried to live my life without you, it wouldn't last.
The Luv Radio Network worldwide. LuvRadioNetwork.com. Educational, inspirational, trending topics, and the hottest hits. With award-winning talk show hosts and personalities. And you made us number one. Thank you. Luv Radio Network, building a network of love.
Already know how we get down. We like to say happy birthday to all those of you that have birthdays this month. Yes, this is your birthday Jimmy Jam shout out. So you can run around the church, you can stand between the pews. If you driving the car, pay attention to the road, because this ain't for you. Okay, you can just shimmy your shoulders, one shoulder at a time or two shoulders, whatever y'all want to do. Mix it up a little bit. That's it right there. That Shoulder pop. That's it. It's your birthday. You can do what you want to do. Hey! Yes, sir. That's it. That's the Baltimore club music. Yeah. The original house party music. Right there. That's what that is. That's the original. You got Philly. Yes, you got PA, you got Jersey, back east. Y'all already know how we do it, East Coast. Or as my aunt would say, it's not technically East Coast. Whatever. Oh, yes. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Sunday Fire listeners. I thank y'all so much for rocking with your girl, okay? For rocking with me today. Thank you, Miss Shay Samuels, for sitting in with us. Y'all enjoyed her, right? I know that's right. Go support her. Make sure y'all look her up. She gave all her information. Make sure you click on that GoFundMe for Luv Radio Network. I'm telling y'all, this is what we do, okay? I do have stocking stuffers to give away. Please email me, inbox me, instant message me, please, so that I can give these away to you. Yes. Make sure, two words, QR code. Technically, that's two letters and one word, but QR code, that way you can have Luv Radio on the go, okay? Because love is where it's at. All right, so we'll be back next week continuing the spotlights for this month. We have the Eastern United Methodist Men's Chorus right here in Baltimore, Maryland. Yes, yes, you do not want to miss it, all right? Y'all know what I'm getting ready to do. Y'all ain't got to go home, but I got to get out of here, okay? Get ready for church, all right? Be blessed, be safe, practice social distance. Love y'all. Peace.
In your ears, got that fire you should hear. Lady Q's in the building, make the noise if you hear. Lift your hands right now.